The first game I'd like to review is Iron Snout. This adorable free game is quite simple enough. You're a kung fu pig fighting back a horde of wolves trying to eat your bacon by using your awesome punching, kicking, and knife throwing skills. It's a game similar to One Finger Death Punch, and nothing but pure repetitive button mashing. Although this game is neither complicated or groundbreaking when it comes to gameplay or mechanics, it's strangely addicting and entertaining to play. It's a great game for people who can't invest hours upon hours into gameplay, but still want that quick hit of killing and carnage. The colorful background and cartoon-like graphics are quite the contrast against the buckets of blood and mass murdering going on around you, which only adds to its charm in my opinion. My only complaint? I wish that there was more variety in the sound effects, especially when it comes to the wolves. The same death groan released over and over and over again can get a little annoying, especially when you've taken out about 50 of these guys. But overall, I was very pleased with this game, especially for what it is. It's a fun, quick, time-wasting game that will certainly feed your need to relieve some stress. There you go, guys and gals, my review for Iron Snout. Ever wonder what it's like to plummet into a world of madness? Well, look no further with the indie horror game, Franbo. In this game, you dive into the traumatized mind of 12-year-old Fran after she witnesses the horrendous murder of her parents and is sent to an asylum. Your goal? To escape the asylum by using your medication and find your beloved cat, Mr. Midnight. This game is a multi-layered experience as you travel in and out of other realities to uncover the truth about your parents' death. It's a game of endless possibilities, and you never know what quite to expect as you progress. This point-and-click game is full of gruesome tasks, otherworldly characters, and mysterious puzzles that will test your problem-solving abilities. The pacing of the plot is a bit slow, and oftentimes the answers leave you with only more questions. The art style reminds me of a child's storybook, which again is quite in opposition to the chaos and extreme horror that Fran is facing. The ending is quite surreal, but perfectly possible considering the dreamlike nature of the game. The interpretation is left up to you. You'll either love it or hate it. I love playing this game and experiencing the horrendous madness through Frambo's eyes. If you're a hardcore RPG horror fan, I have a feeling you'll get enveloped and sucked into this game. So there you go, my friends, my review for Franbo. Moving on to the next game, which I'm sure you figured out from the name, is an amazing remake of the beloved classic you played as a child. Yep, The Oregon Trail. The time? Post-zombie apocalypse. Goal? Get you and your party to the safe haven located across the country while fighting, yep, you guessed it, zombies. You'll have to trade, hunt, repair, and take on odd jobs to get the materials and money you need for your party's survival. But zombies aren't your only enemy. Your company could fall ill from a number of afflictions, from typhoid and dysentery, or even possibly befall other unfortunate circumstances, such as being shot by a stray bullet or being bitten by a zombie when you wander off to pee. The retro pixelated style of this game is a throwback to those you played as a child, and I know for me, certainly brought it feelings of nostalgia. It's a great combination of strategy and shooting, but you also need a little luck on your side, considering that the unlucky events that can occur are random and unpredictable. Oh, and did I mention the zombie deer? Yeah, the zombie deer. Not to mention the times you'll have to put your party members down for the best of everyone. This certainly brought tears to my eyes, especially when I had to put down Batman. This game was a great game to experience, if not a challenging one. It's a must play, so don't miss out. And that concludes this episode of Pawsed. I hope you enjoyed it. If there's any games that you would like to see me play and review, leave a comment down below. I certainly would love to check them out. And you don't forget to check out these amazing games, all downloadable from Steam. Until I post again, guys, keep gaming!